Good, man.
Yeah,
congratulations, man.
Thanks, man.
15. It's pretty awesome. Yep. Plus, I heard you're gonna be in Dancing with the Stars.
Yep, that's what I heard too.
Oh, have you accepted it yet? Or?
Well, yeah, I guess so.
Yeah,
I mean, I don't know.
Did you do a little dancing before?
Oh man,
I heard the noise. Well, I didn't say because I was doing
this. Out, man.
Did you?
This is stressful. I mean, come on, I can dance, but. I forgot all the moves.
Of course you did.
Oh my
God. Have you already started training for it?
Like, no.
Oh, okay.
No.
He's been training his whole life for it.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that's right.
What do you think this is?
That's the right answer.
This is dancing.
It's all about rhythm. Once I get my rhythm going.
I've seen you and Joseph do some moves, you know?
Yeah. Hey, dancing is part of life, so you know, it's gonna be fun, a lot of fun, so for now I'm focused on the fight, you know?
But yeah, talk about Vincent Sende, Mexican fighter, yeah. Mexican style, he's ready to brawl, I guess?
Yeah, I guess so, you know, what's important to me is that, okay, he's shorter than me, I need to keep him on the outside, and so that's the game plan, you know? He's a top fighter, he's been ranked, number 15 in the world in the past. So, he's fought two of the top 10 heavyweights in the world, Charles Martin and Edmund Gerber. So, definitely, you know, I believe he's going to give me good rounds, you know, I'm well prepared. And, come fight night, I will do my best to execute the game plan.
Is this the first Mexican you've ever fought?
Yes.
Because you know how the Mexicans, like, the Mexican style, where they...
Yeah, I don't go into that, you know.
Oh, okay.
I'm not going to fight all Mexicans, you know. I'm going to fight one guy.
Yeah.
And it's going to be Vicente Sandez, so...
I was watching some of his YouTube clips.
That's who I'm prepared for.
Yeah, he seems like a very dangerous fighter, so it's going to be a good fight.
Yeah. Definitely.
Have you got an opponent lined up for Samoa as well? Or?
No, I'm not fighting in Samoa.
You're not?
I'm not fighting in Samoa. There's one. And, yeah. Hey, one step at a time.
What did you think of the Canelo Cotto fight?
I didn't watch it. We're on the flight.
Oh, okay.
So, unfortunately, I didn't watch it. But, you know. What did you think about it?
I thought it was a good fight. I definitely thought Canelo won the fight.
You did?
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah.
Did you agree with that as well?
No, I didn't see it.
Oh, you didn't watch it yet?
So I was, you know...
I think Freddie Roach thought it was a close fight, but yeah. I didn't really think so.
That's pretty much what Kev's been talking all the time, that the younger, bigger guy is going to win.
But the more exciting fight is going to be Canelo versus Gennady Golovkin.
Definitely.
Yeah. Who do you think got that fight?
Well...
Because Gennady is unstoppable at the moment, right?
Yes, he is.
He's on that wave at the
moment. You know, everyone is unstoppable at a certain moment. You know, Ronda was unstoppable.
Jesus, yeah.
Wasn't she? She was the most dangerous woman on the planet one day. And where did she end up the next day? So, you know, everyone is unstoppable until they get beat. That's what it is. I said there's one person who always believes that can beat you.
Yeah.
The whole world might say that no, it can't happen. But if that one person believes, it can be done. And it's as simple as that. And that's why, you know, why I like, you know, fighting. It's all about this man's, one man's belief against the other. You know, you can say all that you want. Gennady Golovkin, he is unstoppable. He looks unstoppable. You know. But see, I think he's going to beat Canelo.
Oh, okay. There we go. We agree. Yeah. Did you watch the Ronda Rousey fight live when it happened?
No, I didn't.
Oh man.
I didn't watch it live, but yeah. What
don't
I saw.
Don't ask him that question.
I did.
Yes, out there. Out there.
Well, I still didn't expect. Oh, I was shocked.
Do you think she can win in the rematch, though? Against Holly Holm?
Let me do.
She fights the right fight and fights to her strengths. And then tries to, and instead of trying to be somebody that she's not,
exactly.
You know, and in mind she thought, Floyd, my hands are as good as any boxer. They are not.
They are not.
So she was trying to be a boxer.
What did you think of that Ring magazine issue? I mean, did you agree with that? She was on the cover of the Ring magazine, you know, and Ring magazine is like the cool box. Hey. Ronda Rousey.
Oh, I didn't know that.
No, I didn't know that either.
Well, you know, it's her own hype that was her, became her biggest enemy.
Yeah,
that's what happened.
No. Did you watch that fight live?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
In-house joke.
It's just that she got outclassed, so that's the sad
totally
bit about
outclassed.
It. Yeah.
But it was like, you know, her whole game plan was wrong.
Yeah.
And that's why you can't. You know, I think she just, in her mind, if you heard me saying before, you can't look past people. I think she just looked past Holly. You know, she just thought, there's no way I can lose this fight. I don't think she gave her enough respect.
Yeah. I mean, everything was wrong about it, right? The weigh-in.
It was great. It was a great fight for professional boxing. You know, it was a great victory for boxing.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
You know, over the greatest ever woman UFC fighter. But you know, hey, she is a great fighter and she'll be back. And, you know, and I'm sure she'll fight, she'll have a different game plan and a different strategy next time.
So if she uses more groundwork and more jiu-jitsu, you know, she might have a better chance against her, right? I mean, if she tries boxing, it's going to be the same story, right?
And well, you got to fight to your strengths. She's not a boxer. She can box, and her hands have been effective against lesser opponents. But Holly's a, you know, incredible boxer. You can't compare her to some of the other stand-up opponents she fought.
Anyway, she's off for 6 months though, so she's suspended for 6 months just because of the brutal knockout. So
yeah, well, that's probably a fair call.
What about Conor McGregor versus Jose Aldo?
It's a great fight. It's a very exciting fight. It's a big, big fight for UFC.
Any predictions?
Well, you know, of course, for, you know, being from Irish descent, you know, Conor's my guy. I want to see Conor win. Love Conor McGregor.
What do you think of his mind games? Like, pretty lethal, right?
He's brutal.
He's the definition of crazy, right?
He is like, he is the Floyd Mayweather of UFC.
I'd agree with that. Jose seems, I don't know, I think he seems...
Very, very good fighter.
He got leg kicked straight from hell though. I mean,
Very good fighter. And I'll tell you what, McGregor would need to take his game up one notch from his last performance.
Yeah, because against Chad Mendes, I don't know, I wasn't very impressed with that. I mean, he did come back, he suffered, you know?
I mean, if he fights the same against Aldo, I think he'd be in trouble.
Yeah. Got some great fights ahead of us, huh?
Some really good fights.
Thank you.
Yeah.